Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilpendi. I am happy to meet you through the video lecture series on the subject heat and mass transfer. And this is lecture number 210 on the module 2 convection heat transfer. And the topic for today's discussion is free convection. And we are going to solve few problems on the free convection. So in the previous session, we discussed the free convection and we defined the bound layer. We defined the Grashof number, Rayleigh number for free convection heat transfer. And we have seen the correlations, various correlations for free convection heat transfer calculation for vertical plate, horizontal plate, cylinder, horizontal cylinder and the sphere. Now using those correlations, we solve few problems in this session, and the learning outcome for the session, the student will be able to solve problems in the free convection using the correlations. And the steps to solve the problem in the free convection, so write down the given data, you read the problem statement carefully and write down the given data. And try to represent the data in the form of a diagram. Particularly, you draw the basic geometry and you indicate the fluid flow and the surface temperature, all the data whatever is given in the problem. Then find the film temperature. So the film temperature equal to TW plus T infinity divided by 2. So the equation is available in the heat and mass transfer data book, and calculate the properties of the fluid from the heat and mass transfer data book. Then calculate the Grashof number. So the equation again, it is given in the data book, and calculate the Rayleigh number, which is the product of Grashof number and the Prandtl number, and classify the flow. So the flow may be laminar or turbulent. If the Rayleigh number GRPR is less than 10 power 9, the flow is laminar. When the GRPR is greater than 10 power 9, the flow is turbulent. Then based on the geometry and the flow regime or flow conditions, you take the Nusselt's equation from the heat and mass transfer data book for a particular problem, and you calculate Nusselt number, substitute the values in the Nusselt equation and calculate the Nusselt number. So from the Nusselt number, you can calculate the heat transfer coefficient, H value for free convection heat transfer. Once you have the H value, then you can calculate the rate of heat transfer, which is Q equal to HA into delta T, where A is the area for the heat transfer. Then you write down the data, summarize the answers from the problem. So you write down the data, you write down the answer at the end of the solution. And this is the heat and mass transfer data book, which is required for taking the properties, taking the correlations for the free convection, heat transfer calculation by C.P. Kodandraman and Subramanian. Heat and mass transfer data book by C.P. Kodandraman and Subramanian. And example number 1, consider a 0.6 by 0.6 meter thin square plate in a room at 30 degree Celsius. One side of the plate is maintained at a temperature of 90 degree Celsius, while the other side is insulated. Determine the rate of heat transfer from the plate by natural convection if the plate is vertical, 2, horizontal with the hot surface facing up, and 3, horizontal with the hot surface facing down. So this is from university examination question paper. And all the questions, whatever I solve here, it is only from Anna University question paper. So it will give the confidence to the student. So the given data, length of the plate is 0.6 meter, width of the plate is 0.6 meter, surface temperature, wall temperature is 90 degree Celsius, and the fluid temperature is 30 degree Celsius. So the properties of the air from the heat and mass transfer data book at the fluid temperature, where the fluid temperature is TW plus T infinity divided by 2, which is 90 plus 30 divided by 2, 60 degree Celsius, and these are all the properties required. So film temperature, kinematic viscosity 18.9, so 10 power minus 6, Prandtl number is 0.696, and thermal conductivity is 0.02896. Then we calculate the beta, coefficient of volume expansion 1 by TF. So the TF value we have to substitute in Kelvin. So 1 by 60 plus 273 equal to 3 into 10 power minus 3 Kelvin to the power minus 1. Then we calculate the Grashof number. Grashof number for a plate, flat plate, is g beta L cube delta t to the mu square. So g is the acceleration due to gravity, b is the volume coefficient of expansion, L is the length of the plate, delta T is the temperature difference, and nu is the kinematic viscosity. Substituting all the numerical values, 9.81 into 3 into 10 power minus 3 into 0.6 to the power 3 into delta T is 90 minus 30 divided by 18.97 10 power minus 6 whole square equal to 1.06 10 power 9. And the Rayleigh number, so the Rayleigh number is GR into PR, which is 1.06 in 10 power 9 into 0.696, which is 7.37 10 power 8. So the flow is laminar. The value GRPR is less than 10 power 9. So the flow is laminar. Then for vertical plate, we calculate the average Nusselt number from page number 135, equation number 1.1. Nusselt number equal to 4 by 3 into 0.508, Prandtl number to the power 0.5. Grashof number divided by 0.952 plus Prandtl number to the power 0.25, and substituting numerical values HL by K, which is Nusselt number, 4 by 3 into 0.508 into 0.698 to the power 0.5 into 1.06 into 10 power 9 divided by 0.952 plus 0.696 to the power 0.25. So calculating, it is 89.99. Then the heat transfer coefficient, H equal to 89.99 into K by L, which is 89.99 into 0.02896 divided by 0.6 equal to 4.34 watts per meter square Kelvin. So the vertical plate heat transfer coefficient 4.34 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the rate of heat transfer for the vertical plate, Q equal to HA into delta T, area equal to 0.6 into 0.6. So calculating, it is 93.7 watts. And the horizontal plate, hot surface facing up, again the heat and mass transfer data book, page number 136, equation 2.1.1. And the characteristic length we have to calculate. So for horizontal plate, characteristic length equal to area by perimeter, which is 0.15. And the Grashof number for the horizontal plate, GR equal to G beta LC to the power 3, delta T divided by nu square, which is 9.813 into 10 power minus 3 into 0.15 to the power 3 into 90 minus 30 will be the kinematic viscosity to the power 2, which is 1.65 10 power 7. Then the Rayleigh number is GRPR is 1.65 10 power 7 into 0.696, which is 1.15 into 10 power 7. The flow again, laminar. Nusselt number for horizontal plate, is Nusselt number equal to 0.54 into GRPR to the power 0.25, which is 0.54 into 1.15 into 10 power 7 to the power 0.25, which is 31.44. Then from the Nusselt number, we calculate the heat transfer coefficient. So H equal to 31.44 into K by LC, which is 31.44 into 0.02896 divided by 0.15 equal to 6.07 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the rate of heat transfer for horizontal plate is HA into delta T again. So 6.07 into 0.6 into 0.6 into 90 minus 30 equal to 131.1 watts. Then the horizontal plate, hot surface facing downward, again the heat and mass transfer data book, page number 137, equation number 2.1.2, and Nusselt number equal to 0.27 into GRPR to the power 0.25. which is 0.27 into 1.15 10 power 7 to the power 0.25, which is 15.72. Then the heat transfer coefficient is H equal to 15.72 into K by LC, which is 15.72 into 0.02896 divided by 0.15 equal to 3.03 watts per meter square Kelvin. Then the rate of heat transfer for horizontal plate, Q equal to HA delta T. So 3.03 into 0.6 into 0.6 into 90 minus 30 is 65.45 watts. Then the answer, net of heat transfer from the plate by natural conversion, if the plate is vertical, 93.7 watts, horizontal with the heating hot surface facing up, 131 watts, and horizontal with the hot surface facing down is 65.45 watts. So among the three, you may notice that the horizontal plate with the hot surface facing up will have the more heat transfer. So that is the conclusion. So that you can also note it down. So when it will be useful when you design a heater in the industrial part. And if we take example number 2, determine the average heat transfer coefficient over a entire length from a vertical plate of height 2 meter to the surrounding air. If it is known that the surface temperature of the plate is 105 degrees Celsius, assume the ambient temperature as 15 degrees Celsius. And the length of the plate is 2 meter, wall temperature is 105 degrees Celsius, and the fluid temperature is 15 degrees Celsius. So the properties of air at the film temperature, so from the for the air from the page number 34, and the film temperature is 105 plus 15 divided by 2 equal to 60 degrees Celsius. So the properties of air at the 60 degrees Celsius, which is 18.97 10 power minus 6, Prandtl number is 0.696, thermal conductivity is 0.02896. Then coefficient of volume expansion beta equal to 1 by T of, which is 1 by 60 plus 273 equal to 3 into 10 power 3 into 10 power minus 3. Then we calculate the Grassof number. Grassof number equal to G beta L to the power 3 into delta T to be nu square. So substituting all the values, 9.81 into 3 into 10 power minus 3 into 2 to the power 3 into 105 minus 15 divided by 18.97 10 power minus 6 whole square, which is 1.96 into 10 power 10. And Rayleigh number, GRPR equal to 1.96 10 power 10 into 0.696 equal to 1.36 into 10 power 10. The flow is turbulent. So for turbulent flow, the page number 136, equation number 2.1, the average heat transfer coefficient Nusselt number equal to 0.1 into GRPR to the power 0.333. So substituting HL by K equal to 0.1 into 1.36 in 10 power 10 to the power 0.33, which is 236.85. And the heat transfer coefficient, average heat transfer coefficient, H equal to 236.85 into K by L, which is equal to 236.85 into 0.02896 divided by 2, which is 3.43 watts per meter square Kelvin. So the answer to the problem, the average heat transfer coefficient is 3.43 watts per meter square Kelvin. Then we take the example number 3, find the convective heat loss from a radiator 0.6 meter wide and 1.5 meter height maintained at a temperature of 90 degrees Celsius in a room at 14 degrees Celsius. Consider the radiator as a vertical plate. And the given data, so W equal to 0.6 meter, L equal to 1.2 meter, surface temperature is 90 degrees Celsius and the fluid temperature is 40 degrees Celsius. Then we have to calculate the properties of the air at film temperature from the heat and mass transfer data book, page number 34. And TF equal to 52 degrees Celsius, 90 plus 14 divided by 2, which is 52 degrees Celsius. Now the properties of air at 52 degrees Celsius. So we have property at 50 and 60. Then we have to do the interpolation. So by interpolating, we will get the value. Kinematic viscosity is 18.154 and 10 power minus 6. And the Prandtl number is 0.6976. And the thermal conductivity is 0.0284. Then the volume coefficient of volume expansion, beta equal to 1 by TF equal to 1 by 52 plus 273 equal to 3.08 into 10 power minus 3. And we calculate the Grassof number, G beta L to the power 3, delta T divided by nu square, so which is 9.81 into 3.08 10 power minus 3 into 1.2 to the power 3 into 90 minus 14 divided by 18.154 into 10 power minus 6 whole square, which is 1.2 into 10 power 10. Then the Rayleigh number, Ra equal to Gr into Pr, which is 1.2 into 10 power 10 into 0.6976 equal to 8.37 into 10 power 9. So the flow is turbulent because the value GrPr is greater than 10 power 9. So the Nusselt's equation for vertical plate from the page number 136, equation 2.1 for turbulent flow. So Nusselt number equal to 0.10 into GrPr to the power 0.333. So, HL by K equal to 0.10 into 8.37 10 power 9 to the power 0.333 equal to 201.5. And the average heat transfer coefficient is H equal to 201.5 into K by L, which is 201.5 into 0.0284 divided by 1.2 equal to 4.77 watts per meter square Kelvin. then the rate of heat transfer Q equal to HA into TW minus T infinity, which is 4.77 into 0.6 into 1.2 into 90 minus 14 equal to 261 watts. So the convective heat loss from the radiator is 261 watts. A vertical cylinder, example number 4, a vertical cylinder 1.5 meter high and 180 millimeter in diameter is maintained at a temperature of 100 degrees Celsius in an atmosphere environment at 20 degrees Celsius. Calculate the heat loss by free convection from the surface of the cylinder. So for vertical cylinder, diameter equal to 0.18 meter, length equal to 1.5 meter and wall temperature is 100 degrees Celsius and the fluid temperature is 20 degrees Celsius. So we have to take the properties at the film temperature. So the film temperature again 60 degrees Celsius. So all the properties at 60 degrees Celsius. Nu equal to 18.97 × 10⁻⁶. Prandtl number equal to 0.696. And K thermal conductivity is 0.02896. And the coefficient of volume expansion is 3 × 10⁻³. And the Grashof number, this is vertical plate, vertical cylinder. Vertical cylinder is considered as a vertical plate. So the correlation, equation, everything for vertical cylinder and vertical plate are very much equal. So the Grashof number is calculated with respect to the length of the cylinder, not the diameter. Remember, normally the student will do the mistake. So this cylinder, they will calculate the Grashof number with respect to diameter. But for vertical cylinder, so you have to calculate the Grashof number with respect to the length of the cylinder. So G beta L to the power 3 into delta T divided by nu square, which is 9.81 × 10⁻³ × 1.5 to the power 3 into 100 minus 20 divided by 18.97 × 10⁻⁶ whole power 2, which is 2.21 × 10⁻¹. So the Rayleigh number GR into PR equal to 2.21 × 10⁻¹ × 0.696, which is 1.54 × 10⁻¹. So the flow is turbulent. The GRPR value is greater than 10⁻⁹. So the flow is turbulent. And the Nusselt's equation for turbulent flow, again the same equation, Nusselt number equal to 0.10 into GRPR to the power 0.333. So HL by K equal to 0.10 into 1.54 × 10⁻¹ whole to the power 0.333 equal to 246.85. Now we calculate the average heat transfer coefficient. So average heat transfer coefficient H equal to 246.85 into K by L, which is 246.85 into 0.02896 divided by 1.5 equal to 4.76 watts per meter square Kelvin. So heat transfer coefficient, average heat transfer coefficient is 4.76. Then we calculate the heat transfer. So Q equal to HA into TW minus T infinity, which is 4.76 into area, surface area of the cylinder pi dl. So pi into 0.18 into 1.5 into 100 minus 20 equal to 322.8 watts. So the answer to the problem, the convective heat loss from the vertical cylinder is 322.8 watts. Then we take example number 5. A horizontal heater plate measuring 1.5 meter by 1.1 meter and at 215 degrees Celsius facing upward is placed in still air at 25 degrees Celsius. So calculate the heat loss by natural convection. The convection film coefficient for the free convection is given by the following empirical relationship. H equal to 3.05 TF to the power 1 by 4, where TF is the mean film temperature in degree Kelvin. So the values are calculated. So L equal to 1.5 meter, width equal to 1.1 meter, TW equal to 215 degrees Celsius and T infinity equal to 25 degrees Celsius, H equal to 3.05 into T into TDF to the power 0.25. So the film temperature, it is 120 degrees Celsius, which is 393 Kelvin, and the properties of the air at 120 degrees Celsius are taken. So nu equal to 25.45 × 10⁻⁶, Prandtl number equal to 0.686 and thermal conductivity is 0.0338 and the beta value, coefficient of volume expansion beta equal to 1 by TF equal to 1 by 120 plus 273 equal to 2.54 × 10⁻³ Kelvin to the power minus 1. So characteristic length for the horizontal plate, so LC equal to area by perimeter, which is 1.5 into 1.1 divided by 2 into 1.5 plus 1.1 equal to 0.32, and the GR value calculating with respect to the characteristic length is 2.39 10 power 8, and Rayleigh number is 1.64 10 power 8, and the heat transfer coefficient. So the equation is given, simplified equation is given. So we can straight away use the equation H equal to 3.05 into TF to the power 0.25, and the TF value is to be substituted in Kelvin. So 3.05 into 393 to the power 0.25 equal to 13.58 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the heat transfer is Q equal to HA into TW minus T infinity equal to 13.58 into area 1.5 into 1.1 into the temperature difference 215 minus 25 equal to 4257.3 watts. So the convective heat loss from the horizontal plate is 4257.3 watts. And if we take example number 6, a thin 80 cm long and 8 cm wide horizontal plate is maintained at a temperature of 130 degrees Celsius. In a large tank full of water at 70 degrees Celsius, estimate the rate of heat input to the plate necessary to maintain the temperature of 130 degrees Celsius. So this is from two university question papers. And the given data, length of the plate is 0.8 meter, width of the plate is 0.08 meter, and the wall temperature is 130 degrees Celsius, and the fluid temperature is 70 degrees Celsius. And we have to take the properties of water at the film temperature from the data book page number 22. And at the film temperature is 100 degrees Celsius, 130 plus 70 divided by 2 equal to 100 degrees Celsius. The properties of water at the film temperature, so kinematic viscosity is 0.293 in 10 power minus 6. Prandtl number equal to 1.74 and thermal conductivity is 0.6804. And the volume coefficient of volume expansion beta equal to 1 by TF equal to 1 by 100 plus 270 equal to 2.68 10 power minus 3. Then you calculate the characteristic length for the horizontal plate, so which is area divided by the perimeter, so which is 0.8 into 0.08 divided by 2 into 0.8 plus 0.08 equal to 0.036 meter. So that is area is W into L, perimeter into 2 times of W plus L. And the Grass of number with respect to the characteristic length, so GR equal to G beta LC into the power 3 into delta T divided by nu square. So substituting all the numerical values, the Grass of number equal to 8.57 10 power 8. Then we calculate the Rayleigh number. So Rayleigh number is GRPR, which is 8.57 10 power 8 into 1.74, which is 14.91 10 power 8. And for heated surface facing up, horizontal plate heated surface facing up, so heat and mass transfer data book, page number 136, equation number 1.1. So Nusselt number equal to 0.15 into GRPR to the power 0.333, which is 0.15 into 14.91 10 power 8 to the power 0.333 equal to 170.16. So the average heat transfer coefficient is 170.16 into K by LC, which is 170.16 into 0.6804 divided by 0.036 equal to 3216 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the heat transfer from the horizontal surface facing up, so Q equal to HA plus HA into TW minus T infinity, which is 3216 into 0.8 into 0.08 into 130 minus 70 equal to 12,349.4 watts. Then Nusselt number for horizontal surface, heated surface facing down. Again, heat and mass transfer data book, page number 137, equation 2.1.2. So Nusselt number equal to 0.27 into GRPR to the power 0.25, which is 0.27 into 14.91 into 10 power 8 to the power 0.25 equal to 53. Now the heat transfer, average heat transfer coefficient is 53 into K by LC, which is 53 into 0.6804 divided by 0.036. Which is 1001.7 watts per meter square Kelvin. Then the heat transfer for horizontal plate where the hot surface is facing down, so H equal to Q equal to HA into delta T, so 1001.7 into 0.8 into 0.08 into 130 minus 70 equal to 3846.5 watts. So the convective heat loss from the horizontal plate from both surfaces 12,349.4 plus 3,846.5 equal to 16,195.9 watts. This is the total amount of heat transfer from the horizontal plate. And we take example number 9. Your square plate of 60 centimeter side and 120 centimeter is exposed to air at 20 degrees Celsius. Find out the heat loss from both sides of the plate by free convection when the plate is kept vertical and also when the plate is horizontal, kept horizontal. So the given data, length equal to W equal to 0.6 meter, TW surface temperature is 120 degrees Celsius and the fluid temperature is 20 degrees Celsius and the properties of air at the film temperature. So 120 plus 20 divided by 2 equal to 70 degrees Celsius. So the film temperature is 70 degrees Celsius. Now the properties of air at 70 degrees Celsius, kinematic viscosity is 20.02 10 power minus 6 and Prandtl number is 0.694, thermal conductivity is 0.02966 and the coefficient of volume expansion beta equal to 1 by Tf, which is 1 by 70 plus 273 equal to 2.91 10 power minus 3. For vertical plate, the GR number, Grashof number is GR equal to G beta L to the power 3 delta T by nu square. Substituting numerical values, Grashof number equal to 1.55 into 10 power 9. Then we calculate the Rayleigh number, GRPR, which is 1.55 into 10 power 9 into 0.694, which is 1.08 into 10 power 9. For heater, Nusselt number from the heat and mass transfer data book, equation page number 136, Nusselt number equal to 0.825 plus 0.387 GRPR to the power 1.167 divided by 1 plus 0.492 divided by Prandtl number to the power 0.5625 whole to the power 0.296 everything to the power 2, which is equal to substituting numerical values. Carefully substituting numerical values and using the calculator carefully, the Nusselt number equal to 127.1. So HL by K equal to 127.1. Then calculating the average heat transfer coefficient, H equal to 127.1 into K by L, which is 127.1 into 0.02966 divided by 0.6 equal to 6.28 watts per meter square Kelvin. Then heat transfer from both surface of the both sides of the vertical plate, 2 into HA into TW minus T infinity, which is 2 into 0.628 into 0.6 into 0.6 into 120 minus 20 equal to 452.16 watts. When the plate is horizontal, horizontal plate heated surface facing upward, so the characteristic length AC equal to area by perimeter, which is 0.15, and the Grashof number with respect to the characteristic length, which is 2.4 into 10 power 7. So we substitute here LC to the power 3. So substituting all the numerical values, Grashof number equal to 2.4 into 10 power 7. And the Rayleigh number is GRPR, which is 2.4 into 10 power 7 to 0.694, which is 1.66 into 10 power 7. Then Nusselt number for heater surface facing upward. So page number 136, equation number 2.1.1. So Nusselt number equal to 0.15 into GRPR to the power 0.333. Substituting numerical values 0.15 into 1.66 into 10 power 7 to the power 0.333 equal to 38. And the average heat transfer coefficient calculating H equal to 38 into K by LC, which is 38 into 0.02966 divided by 0.15 equal to 7.5 watts per meter square Kelvin. So the heat transfer for the top surface is from the top surface of the horizontal plate. So, HA into TW minus T infinity, which is 7.5 into 0.6 into 0.6 into 120 minus 20 equal to 270 watts. And similarly, horizontal plate, hot surface facing down, equation page number 137, equation 2.1.2, and we calculate the Nusselt number equal to 0.27 into GRPR to the power 0.25. So, substituting the value of GRPR and calculating, it is 17.23. Nusselt number equal to 17.23. And the heat transfer coefficient is H equal to 17.23 into K by LC, which is 17.23 into 0.02966 divided by 0.15, which is 3.4 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the heat transfer from the bottom surface of the horizontal plate, Q equal to HA into TW minus T infinity, which is 3.4 into 0.6 into 0.6 into 120 minus 20 equal to 122.4 watts. Then the total heat transfer from the horizontal plate, 270 plus 122.4 equal to 392.4 watts. So for a vertical plate, the heat transfer is 452.16, and for a horizontal plate, the heat transfer is 392.4 watts. And we take example number 8. A two-stroke motorcycle petrol engine cylinder consists of 15 annular fins. If outside and inside diameter of each fin are 200 mm and 100 mm respectively, the average fin surface temperature is 475 degrees Celsius and they are exposed to air at 25 degrees Celsius. Calculate the heat transfer rate from the fins for the following condition. 1. When the motorcycle is at rest. 2. When the motorcycle is running at a speed of 60 km per hour. The fin may be idealized as a single horizontal flat plate of same area. So the given data, number of fin n equal to 15, inside diameter is 0.1 meter, outside diameter is 0.2 meter, wall temperature is 475 degrees Celsius, fluid temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. We have to take the properties of air at the film temperature. So film temperature equal to 475 plus 25 divided by 2 equal to 250 degrees Celsius. So the properties of air at 250 degrees Celsius from the heat and mass transfer data book. So, new kinematic viscosity is 40.61 10 power minus 6, Prandtl number is 0.677 and thermal conductivity is 0.044268. And we calculate the coefficient of volume expansion beta equal to 1 by TF, which is 1.912 in 10 power minus 3. And when the motorcycle is at rest, we have to do the free convection calculations. So, the characteristic length for the horizontal plate, so 2 into area by perimeter, so the 2 into pi by 4 into dO square minus dI square divided by pi into dO in minus dI, which is dO plus dI divided by 2, which is 0.15 meter. And calculating the Grashof number with respect to the characteristic length. So, G beta LC to the power 3 delta T will be nu square. Substituting all the numerical values, Grashof number equal to 17.27 10 power 6. And the Rayleigh number equal to GRPR equal to 17.27 10 power 6 into 0.677 equal to 1.169 10 power 7. So, horizontal plate heated surface facing down and Nusselt number from the Nusselt number equation is 0.27 into GRPR to the power 0.25, which is 0.27 into 1.169 to the into 10 power 7 to the power 0.25, which is 15.78. And calculating the heat transfer coefficient, so H equal to 15.78 into K by LC, which is 15.78 into 0.04268 divided by 0.15, which is 4.49 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the heat transfer from the bottom surface of the horizontal plate, so the heat transfer equation, this Nusselt's equation from the equation number 2.1.1, page number 137, so Q equal to HA into TW minus T infinity, area equal to pi by 4 into dO square minus dI square into number of fins. So, substituting 4.49 into pi by 4 into 0.2 square minus 0.1 square into 15 fins into temperature difference, calculating 703.74 watts. And for the Nusselt number for heated surface facing up, so here facing down, now the Nusselt number for heated surface facing down, so from the page number 136, equation number 2.1.1, so, Nusselt number equal to 0.15 into GRPR to the power 0.333, which is 0.15 into 1.16 10 power 7 into to the power 0.333 equal to 33.86. And calculate the heat transfer coefficient. So, H equal to 9.63 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the amount of heat transfer equal to HA into delta T. It is calculating HA into TW minus T infinity. H equal to area equal to pi by 4 dO square minus dI square into n number of fins into TW minus T infinity. Substituting all the numerical values, the heat transfer here is 1530.8 watts. So the total heat removed from the horizontal fin 713.74 plus 1530.8 equal to 2244.54 watts. when the motorcycle is running at a speed of 60 kilometers per hour, which is 16.67 meters per second, so the hydraulic diameter we have to calculate. Hydraulic diameter equal to 4A divided by the perimeter. So A is the area of the surface and P is the perimeter of the surface for the cylindrical system. Area equal to pi by 4 into DO square minus DI square. Perimeter equal to pi into DO minus DI. So finally it is DO minus DI, which is 0.1 meter. And here we have to use force convection for internal flow. Reynolds number equal to U dH by nu, which is 16.67 into 0.1 divided by 40.61 10 power minus 6 equal to 41049. And for Nusselt number, flow over cylinder, equation 2.1.1 from the page number 116. Nusselt number equal to C into Reynolds number to the power M, Prandtl number to the power 0.333, which is equal to C equal to 0.0266 and the M equal to 0.805. So 0.0266 Reynolds number to the power 0.805 into Prandtl number to the power 0.333. Substituting numerical values, Nusselt number equal to 120.83 and the heat transfer coefficient equal to 120.83 into K by DH, which is 120.83 into 0.042868 divided by 0.1, which is 51.57 watts per meter square Kelvin. Then we calculate the heat transfer. Once again, Q equal to HA into TW minus T infinity, which is H into area now, pi by 4 D square into N. So, 2, it is taken for two sides of the fin and calculating into TW minus T infinity, substituting numerical values. So, amount of heat transfer for forced convection, it is 16,395 watts. So, the heat transfer when the motorcycle is at rest is 2,254.4 watts and the heat transfer when the motorcycle is running at 60 kilometers per hour is 16,395 watts. So, we solved some 8 problems here in the free convection. We have a few more problems in the free convection, so we will see in the next lecture. And these are all the reference book I used for preparing the notes. You can also refer to it for additional information. I have published a book on the subject. You can refer to it for more problems on the free convection heat transfer. And if you have any queries, you can write to me to my mail ID. I will sincerely answer. Until then, thank you. And you can also pass your comments. So after seeing the YouTube video, so if you give your comments, that will be useful for me to improve further in the video lectures.